Praise the Lord. God bless you. Praise the Lord. God bless you. My name is Minister Red, pastor of Christ Our Life Ministries, located in Augusta, Georgia on 308 Rose Street, directly behind the Walmart Lowe's on Bobby Jones Expressway, Interstate 520 heading west. I pray that you'll join us for our worship services every Sunday at 10 a.m. and for Bible study every Thursday night at 7 p.m. I'm sure you'll be blessed, just as well as I know you'll be blessed by today's message. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you, Brother Roland. Thank you for joining me today. I love you. I know you and your beautiful wife is here to support your pastor. Amen. I missed y'all. Amen. That Tuesday week service. Amen. And then from Tuesday to Sunday, that seems too long to me. Amen. I just felt like I wasn't with y'all this week. Amen. But hallelujah. God is good all the time. He blessed us to see another day in the land of the living, another Father's Day. Hallelujah. God bless you. Happy Father's Day to you too, Brother Peachy. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there. But especially, happy Father's Day to our father. God bless you, Cousin Pat. I love you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Pat, for joining me. Amen. I know you got your own church services that you go to, but you check in with your cousin and support your cousin, and I love you for that, Cousin Pat. Thank you, Pat. Tell my Aunt Hester, I said I love him. Tell Calvin, your brother, I said I love him, and happy Father's Day to him. Amen. And to your husband, Lawrence, as well. Hallelujah. God bless you. Thank you for joining me, Sister Peachy. Thank you for the happy Father's Day. I love y'all. Love you, love you, love you. Amen. And I'm happy to be back before your presence again today. God got a strong word for us today. I tell you, I'm telling you, sometimes them messages be strong, very strong, but this is one of them strong ones that's going to, amen, get down into the joints and marrow of the bone area, amen. As if all my messages probably don't get down there already. But today's is, thank you, Cousin Pat. Happy Father's Day, amen. Let us, amen, play a praise and worship song and then give other people time to join in. God bless you, Brother Kirk Smith, my friend. Happy Father's Day to you, sir. Amen. We're going to go before the Lord with a praise and worship song and then give other people time to join the telecast. Amen. On this beautiful Father's Day.
Draw me close to you.
Oh, on this Father's Day, Lord.
Never.
Happy Father's Day, Brother Smith.
Never let me go.
Never let me go on this Father's Day. I lay it all down again. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
You say I'm your friend.
Oh, Lord. Thank you for saying that I'm your friend.
You are mine. Desire.
Oh, Brother Kirk Smith, I can hear you singing this. I can hear you singing this.
No one else will do.
Oh, God bless you. Thank you for joining me today.
No one else can take your place.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. do. Tell me wanting to work in you. Tell
no
him.
One else.
No one else. Take your place. Tell him that.
Not
when I want to feel the warmth of your embrace. You gotta tell him that. Help me. Come on now. Make its way into today's message through my animate nature that I pray will not have any involvement in today's message. Oh Lord, we love you today. Oh, we submit to the anointing of your word today that will be coming through my vocal cords unto the ears of the hearer. We love you today, Father. It's in Jesus' mighty name that we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Ann. I love you. Thank you for joining me today. Thank everybody for joining today's telecast. Amen. God is looking for dead men, men who will not choke his word. Hallelujah. Let us go down with verse of scripture that, amen, I've been using as my foundation, I think, all year. I know I started it in January the 1st. Amen. Hallelujah. And you, because I want to make sure that you know that this verse is addressed to you. And why I like it. And you. Because I want to make sure that you know exactly what this verse is saying. Because it is you that he has made alive. It's you that he has quickened. You who was dead in trespasses and in sin. He done made you alive. When you were dead. See, when you were dead in trespasses and in sin, wherein in time past. See, that's why he didn't want Lot's wife looking back. That's why the Bible says, and look at any man having put his hand to the plow and looking back is not fit for the kingdom of God. Wherein in time past, we're not going to look back to the past. When you walk according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, walking. That's the second time we're going to suffer. In time past, he walked. Now walking with. Now we know we're supposed to be walking by faith. Walking with the Spirit. See, walking with the Spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. I hope you have not been walking with that spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. Notice it says, walking with the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. See, he's telling it to the people that he had quickened. He's telling them, he's like, I hope you're not walking with the spirit that now working. Because if you're walking with the spirit, if you, the believer, is now walking with the Spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience, you are a choker. You're going to choke the Word of God. You see that? That's the heart, and it's being choked. You see, the heart is the symbol of love. Being choked. Being choked. Oh, we're going to get into that today. I got the definitions on the board. We're going to break this thing down today. You're going to, when the day's message ends, you're going to know if you are a choker of God's word. Let us go to the board first before I go into my Genesis 2, 7, and 8. John 1 and 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. God is looking for dead men. Men who will not choke his word. Definition of the word choke. Difficulty breathing so as to make movement of air impossible. To make the movement of air impossible so that a person can continue living. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and God is looking for dead men who would not choke his word, which is him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Okay, God, you a spirit, and you want me to worship you in spirit and in truth. What type of spirit are you, God? 1 John 4:8. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. He is the spirit of love. And God is looking for dead men who will not choke this spirit of love. He's looking for dead men. He told us that what was going to choke that word and let us go to it. And the Lord God formed man, the free will being, we only have a free will, of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. So, difficulty breathing so as to make movement of the breath of life impossible. He breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the free will spirit became a living soul. God bless you, Kobe. Love you, classmate. Kobe, my 1983 classmate, amen. And the Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the free will man, free will being, whom he had formed. And the Lord God took the free will man, free will being, and put him into the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. And the Lord God commanded the free will being, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not take information from it. For in the day that thou takest information from it thereof, thou shalt surely die. Why? Because the information that they was going to receive and that they received from this tree is the knowledge that we're dealing with today, and it is the reason why we surely die, because it's choking the breath of life, which is the word of God, out of us. The knowledge is choking the word of God out of people's hearts. It's choking it. It's choking. Them chains you see choking that heart of love, that is the knowledge from that tree. Choking the life of God out of every man walking this planet Earth. And through this mess that's going on in the world today, you can see that it is choking believers. People that say they're believers of God. People that say they saved, sanctified, and Holy Ghost filled with the Holy Ghost, that will give them the power. To give them the power to cast down imagination and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing that knowledge into captivity and every thought to the obedience of Christ. Thank you, Niece Taisha, I love you. Casting down new images in the mind. And because we won't allow the word of God to cast down the new images in the mind that we're encountering in 2020, the word of God is being choked. Oh, I tell you, no, it is not being choked by unbelievers. It's being choked by believers. The unbelievers never received it to walk in it. So when God is saying that his word is being choked, he's talking to the church. It is the church that's choking the word of God. It ain't the world. No, it's the people that say they are part of the church, that love the world, and that are talking the word of God in their life, and they bringing that mess into the church, and it's got the whole church in confusion, that the word of God says that he is not even the author of confusion. Don't worry about that. We're going to get there. We're going to get there. I promise you we're going to get there. And because Adam took this knowledge that God knew was going to take his word, and that's why God told him, you're going to surely die because this knowledge is going to choke everything that the breath of life would have told you to do. You're not going to do it no more because this knowledge is going to be stronger than that breath of life. He didn't give him life. He gave him breath. Adam had to choose the life. And before he chose the life, he ate from this tree of knowledge of good and evil that chokes him every time he hears the life in his ears. Don't worry about that. We're going to get there. And then to Adam, he said, because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of thy wife. I tell you today, because some of y'all have hearkened unto the voice of the prince of the power of the air that's going on in the world today and has eaten of the not tree and been taking their knowledge of which I commanded thee, saying, thou shalt not take in that information. Curse is the ground for thy sake. In sorrow, here we go, in sorrow shalt thou take in this information all the days of thy life. Thorns, there we go, that's the word I want right there, thorns. Thorns also and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herb of the field. Thorn. Thorn denotes sin, sorrow, and hardship. The thorn is one of the most ancient symbols in the world. Together with the rose, it represents pain and pleasure. 2 Corinthians 12, 7 through 10. Paul says, and lest I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of the revelations, because God was giving Paul some serious revelations. And Paul says, lest I should be exalted above measure. Because, you know, God has dealt to every man a measure of faith. God ain't gave Pastor Red no more faith than he's given you. If there is a difference in our faith, it has to do with our walk and our belief in that walk. That is the only difference. That is the only thing I would have on you, is the way I walk and how far I allow that faith to walk with me. That is the only difference. I'm no more anointed than you. The anointing that's on me is from the word of God. The same word that you have. I am no more anointed than you. And the reason why is because of this verse right here. Lest I, Pastor Red, should be exalted above measure through the abundance of revelations that was given to me, a thorn in the flesh. Oh, I got a thorn. I tell you, I got a thorn in the flesh. But just like Paul didn't tell you his thorn, neither am I going to tell you mine. It is a past thorn that Satan likes to bring up and buffet me with every time I think I'm more godly than y'all. That was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above measure, above even y'all's level of knowledge of the word of God. For this thing I besought the Lord thrice, that it might depart from me. And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for you, because we're saved by grace. For my strength is made perfect in weakness. Definition of the word perfect. Free from flaw and defect, faultless. For my strength is made faultless in weakness. God said, if I can keep you weak, if I can keep you weak by keeping this thorn in your flesh, then my strength will be made perfect in you. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of the outer resurrection life of Jesus may rest upon me. Therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in necessities, in persecutions, in distresses for the outer resurrection of the life of Jesus' sake. For when I am weak, then am I strong in the Lord. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you. This day, 21 June 2020, Father's Day. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you because of this message that you're about to receive today. That I have set before you, I'm going to set before you today, life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, choose life, that both thou and thy seed, your children, may live. What does it mean to say may live? Live without being choked. So difficult to bring so as to make movement of the word of God impossible. Jesus says in John 6:63, it is the spirit that quickeneth, giveth life. There it is. There it is. And you have been quickened, made alive. It is the spirit that quickeneth, that giveth life. God is a spirit. It is God that giveth life. The flesh profits nothing. He ain't giving the flesh nothing. Do all your Black Lives Matter movement all you want. God ain't thinking about the external man. He's only focused on the internal man, getting him to love. Feel free to get off my Facebook page whenever you want. Don't let me stop you from checking out. The words that I speak. This is Jesus talking here. Jesus says, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit, they are God. They are love, and they are life. And people may come into church hearing this word, but they're choking it. God is looking for dead men. See, we're supposed to be dead in Christ. Dead men who will not choke his words when they hear it. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore choose life, that thou both thou and thy seed may live. It is the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. 2 Chronicles 16:9. The eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you. The eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong. God bless you, Dwayne. Thank you, my friend. To show himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect towards him. Whose heart is flawless, faultless before, towards him. God bless you, Brother Bales. Thank you, my friend. The Lord's eyes is all over this earth, going throughout the whole earth, showing himself strong in the behalf. He's only showing himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is faultless towards him. But today he finding a lot of faulty hearts because their heart is not towards him. Nobody, I'm gonna say it. 98, I'm going up to 98 today. 98% of God's professing believers' heart is not perfect towards him. It's perfect towards the movement taking place in the world right now. Nobody is focusing on the water walker. Everybody done turned into Peter and took their eyes off the water walker and are now looking at the situation going on in the world. And that is causing them to have a faulty heart towards him. And he wants to show himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect towards him. Not towards no movement. Don't worry about it. I got the message for y'all. We ain't even hit the verses yet that I'm going to crush your toes with. Herein thou hast done foolishly, therefore from henceforth thou shalt have wars. We're going to have a bunch of wars. Civil wars. Racial wars. Confederate flag wars. Hating the president wars. Straight people versus gay people wars. Henceforth thou shalt have wars. Because we don't got a heart that's perfect towards him. So whatever our heart is perfect towards, he's telling us, since your heart is that towards that way, I'm going to make sure that you have wars that way. And I'm not going to show myself strong on your behalf in that way, because I am the way, the truth, and the life. Here we go. Mark 4:2-7. And he taught them many things by parables, and he said unto them in his doctrine. God bless you, Corey. Happy Father's Day to you. Hearken. Behold, there went out a sower to sow. And it came to pass, as he sowed, some fell by the wayside, and the fowls of the air came and devoured it up. And some fell on stony ground, where it had not much earth, and immediately it sprang up because it had no depth of earth. But when the sun was up, it was scorched because it had no root. I'm going to tell you, we talked about this Tuesday. Root out of a dry ground. Isaiah 53:2. He will come to us as a tender plant and as a root out of a dry ground. Because But they had no Christ life. It, the life they had withered away. God bless you, Sister Selena. Thank you for joining me. And some fell among thorns. There we go. There we go. There we go. He's talking to Adam. Cursed is the ground without sin. In sorrow shalt thou eat of it all the thorns also, and thistles shall it bring forth to thee. You see, so the word had to be, because of the curse on the earth suit, the word fell among the thorns, because that's what the curse brought to the Adamic nature. Some fell among them thorns, and the thorns grew up. What is the thorns? I tell you, we already know what the thorns is. Paul tells us, that was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above measure. And some fell amongst the things that I would be exalted with, that would exalt me. And the exalted thing grew up and it choked the word of God, and it yielded no fruit. Now you know that God told man to be fruitful and multiply. And the reason why, love, joy, peace, long-suffering, meekness, kindness, temperance is not being yielded today is because y'all have allowed the situation of today's world to choke the word of God out of y'all. Not me. I'm going to tell you right now. I ain't been choked not one second. The air, the word of God, is still flowing in me like it flowed before Officer Chauvin's knee went on George Floyd's neck. We're going to talk about that today, too. Don't worry, and you ain't getting over. And others fell on good ground and did yield fruit that sprang up in the creek. You know what that good ground is? Jesus told Peter, upon this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. The good ground is the Christ life. The Christ life will yield fruit, and that fruit will increase. And it'll bring forth some 30, and some 60, and some 100. And he said unto them, he that hath ears to hear, let him hear. The sower soweth the word, Mark 4, 14 through 17. And these are they by the wayside. The word is sown, and when they have heard it, Satan cometh immediately and taketh away the word that was sown in their hearts. You see, Satan didn't choke it. Satan took it. He didn't choke it. That's what I want us to focus on today. God is looking for dead men. Men who will not choke his word. See, Satan don't come to choke the word. Satan can't choke the word of God, because the word of God has put him in a place where he doesn't have the ability to choke it. But we can choke it. He can't choke it. We can choke it. We can choke it through our unbelief. The sower soweth the word of life. These are they by the wayside where the word is sown, but when they have heard it, Satan comes immediately and taketh away the word that was sown in their hearts. That's why the Bible, that's why it says the Lord's eyes run to and fro throughout the whole earth, destroying so strongly in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect towards him. So we know the first ones don't have a perfect heart towards him, because the word never got in that, because Satan cometh immediately and took that word away. How did he take it? They didn't believe it. And so the way Satan takes it away is he takes it away through your unbelief. He takes away the word that was sown in their hearts. And these are they which are sown on stony ground. Let's see the stony ground. We got the wayside. Let's see the stony grounds. Who, when they have heard the word, immediately receive it with gladness. These are the Holy Ghost people that run up and down the church aisle, walk around in them stupid three-piece pinstripe suits, sitting up in the pulpit like they more holier than thou. The sisters that sit out there with their white dresses on. You ain't getting over. You first ladies that think that you all that. Yeah, here we go. These are they which are sown on stony ground, who when they have heard the word, immediately you real happy. You come to church, you happy. But you have no Christ life in you. You have no outer resurrection of Jesus in you. And so you endure for a time. Afterward, when affliction or persecution arises, when a white officer choke out a black man on the street, when two white men shoot a black guy while he's out jogging, when officers shoot through a house and kill a female, when officers shoot the guy in the back that took his taser and was going to tase him, when that arises for the word's sake, immediately they are offended. But this is the one for today. And these are they which are sown among the thorns. Oh yeah. Thorns also and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, must the Adam in nature. Lest I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of the revelations that was given to me, a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above measure. So what did this say? Thorns and thistles. So this verse right is telling us Satan is going to run you up the wall every day. If Paul is saying here that it was given to him a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan, the thorn in the flesh is the messenger, the words of Satan. The knowledge, the tree of the knowledge of the good and evil information is going to buffet Paul all the days of his life. These are they which are sown among the thorns, such as hear the word, and the cares of this world. But you have been quickened, who was dead in trespasses and in sins, wherein in time past ye walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the walking with the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. The cares of this world and the deceitfulness of riches and of other things and the lust of other things enter in and choke the word, and it becometh unfruitful. The cares of this world and the deceitfulness of riches and the lust of other things enter in and choke the word. See, them is the thorns. See, he says, and these are they which are sown among the thorns. Then he tells us what the thorns are. Because he told Adam, thorns also and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herb of the field. But what are the thorns? The thorns are the cares of the world, that's a thorn. The deceitfulness of riches, that's a thorn. The lust of other things, that's a thorn. Enter in. And it chokes the word, and it becometh unfruitful. God is looking for dead men, men who will not choke the word. You got church people, they care too much about what's going on in the world. When what's going on in the world is going on because of the thorns that is being produced in our lives through the messenger of Satan to buffet us. The word of God is being choked by three things. Oh yeah, that's right, Sister Selena. Everything we can't take to heaven. Oh, Sister Selena, that was beautiful. Y'all better hear what she just wrote. The cares of this world, the deceitfulness of riches, and the lust of other things enter in, and it chokes the word. And that choking has caused 98% of God's professing believers to become lukewarm. Revelations 3:15-16. I know thy works. I know what you believe. Because the cares of the world and the deceitfulness of riches and the lust of other things that enter in have choked your belief. I know what you believe. That thou art neither cold nor hot. That you can't breathe good. Nor can you not breathe at all. I would that thou wert that you couldn't breathe at all, or that you could breathe flawlessly. So then, because you decide when you want to allow the word to be have free course in your life, and when you want to choke it, when you want to let the word have free course. See, you determine when the word has free course, and you determine when the word is choked. Because thou art a choker / non-choker, I don't know what you're going to be. I don't know if on Monday you're going to choke me, and on Tuesday you're not going to choke me, and then Wednesday you're going to choke me, and then the double-minded man is unstable in all his ways because you choke me today, but you don't choke me tomorrow. You're lukewarm because thou art a choker / non-choker, and neither cold nor hot. I will spew thee out of my mouth. Because you don't know what you want to be. You want to move with the black people today, then you want to run up and be with the church people tomorrow like you're a person of love. You love exactly what this right here says. You have a perfect heart towards whatever you want to be. Have a perfect heart towards, but you won't have a perfect heart towards him 24 hours of the day. Because that's what he's looking for. His eyes is running to and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is flawless towards him 24 hours of the day in thorny situations. In thorny situations. Here we go. Last verse of scripture here. We're going to spend a little bit of time. Isaiah 59:1-4. The reason why we forget. The reason why we forget is because the cares of the world and the deceitfulness of riches and the lust of other things enter in and they choke the words. Oh yes, Sister Selena. Yeah, but oh yeah, the word is received when we want a blessing. But don't mess with my emotions alone. You are so right. Don't do that. Don't do that. That's all we want is a blessing. That's all we want to do is come to church and hear the pastor speak a blessing. You don't ever want to hear the pastor. I tell you, this is toes stepping on ministry. I tell it like it is, like it is. Here, I'm going to tell it like it is, like it is. Oh yeah, that's what I'm going to tell it. Behold, Isaiah, this is what Isaiah says. Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened. So why is the Lord's hand shortened? The eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect towards him. His hand is shortened because our heart is perfect towards something other than him. That it cannot save. Neither is his ear heavy that it cannot hear. God, why can't you hear me? The eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect towards him. I can't hear you because your cares for this world, your deceitfulness of riches, and the lust of other things have entered in and choked my hand and is choking my ear. The Lord's hand is not short. His hand ain't short. His hand is still as long as it was when it reached down and picked Peter up out of the water. His hand is still long that it reached down and parted the Red Sea for the children of Israel. But verse 2 says, but your iniquities have separated between you and your God, your word. Your iniquities have choked the word of God. And your sins have hid. You notice it says he didn't hide his face. Your sins have hid his face from you. He ain't hid his face from you. Your sin. If our gospel be hid, it is not hid because God hid it. It is hid because the God of his world has blinded the minds of them, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ should shine unto them. Your sins have hid his face from you, that he will not hear you, because your sins have put earplugs in God's ears. You have issued God earplugs. And God don't want you to give him earplugs. He wants to hear you, but when you talk the word of God, see, earplugs, I'm a psychic guy. I give guys earplugs so that they can choke out anything over 85 dB so it won't damage their hearing. So once it goes over 85 decibels, it's damaging to the eardrum. So I make them wear earplugs in areas of the plant so that their ears, their hearing won't be damaged. Your sins have, you have given God earplugs that he can't hear you no more. For your hands are defiled with blood, which is Cain's spirit. Cain had Abel's blood on his hands. David had Uriah's blood on his hands. Saul had Stephen's blood on his hands. And your fingers with iniquity. That's a shame. The fingers is on the hand. I'm talking about, okay, I got blood on my hands, but I got iniquity on my fingers. The fingers is the hand. Iniquity. Immoral or grossly unfair behavior. You got unfair behavior on your fingers. You ain't know because you out there, because you know you be typing all that Black Lives Matters mess. You got the stealing televisions and rioting and stuff, but you said you're a Christian though. You out there kneeling down for 8.46 seconds, but God can't get you to climb your lazy tail out of bed in the morning for 2 minutes and bow down to him. Your sins have hid his face from you. The eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect, free from defect, flawless towards him. Your lips have spoken lies. Your tongue has muttered perverseness. Perverseness. Deliberate and stubborn unruliness to discipline. Wickedness. Resistance to authority. You know, you go out there, you can say you're peacefully protesting, but you're peacefully protesting against authority that did nothing wrong. Officer Chauvin did something wrong. Them 2 men that shot Ahmaud Arbery did something wrong. The people that fired into Breonna Taylor's house wrongfully did something wrong. The officer in Atlanta, to me, that guy did nothing wrong. The video shows that they took the guy out the car, handcuffed him while they was in the process of handcuffing. The guy turned around, started fighting him, took off and grabbed his taser. The police officer shot him in the back and killed him. I tell you, if I would have been that police officer, I tell you, you would not have heard of that guy dying from a bullet in the back. I'd have put the bullet dead in his forehead. You would not have saw a video of me as a police officer of somebody snatching my taser and running and turning around, tasing me with it. I'm shooting you. I'm killing you. say what you want to say. But you know what, you know what? You know, you black people, y'all don't see that. The video was clearly shown that the guy was drinking and driving. The guy was getting handcuffed, and then he decided he wanted to fight the authority. I would have put a bullet in his head. I would have left his back alone. I would have put the bullet dead in his head. I would have put the bullet right where David put the stone in Goliath's head. And you could have said what you wanted to say. Let the video be shown for what it is. The police officers was doing everything to the book. You just want to see what you want to see. Because you live in perverseness. Your mouth mutters perverseness. None calleth for justice. Oh, y'all out there saying no justice, no peace. God says vengeance is mine. So justice is going to come through God, not through your movement. None calleth for justice. Whosoever calleth on the name of the Lord shall be saved. But you ain't come because your eyes ain't towards, and your heart ain't perfect towards him. Your heart is perfect towards the cares of this world, the deceitfulness of riches, and the other things, and the lust of other things. Oh yeah, Sister Selena. Yeah, he was out with his girlfriend and not at home with his wife and children. Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say, Sister Selena. We got to, I don't want my Sister Selena, watch what I'm finna say here in a second. You think that's something? Watch what I'm finna say with this next green word, the green letter. None, nor any pleading for truth. There it is, Sister Selena. Nobody pleaded for truth. But the video showed us the truth. They trust in vanity. Here we go. I love that word. Excessive pride in one's appearance. You don't know, the black people, they trust in their black pride. Like their black pride's gonna get them somewhere. It's going to get you put into the lake of fire, I promise. I told you, if you did not see my Facebook page this week, you better go back and look at it, because I put on now, my name is Pastor Red. You better look at what I put under that, or what a pastor is. I preach the word of God. I do not preach to lift up the pride of your appearance, your blackness. And speak lies. Oh, this is the one I wanted. That's why I highlighted it in red. And speak lies. They speak lies. That's the problem I got with this thing, the lies. When George Floyd was killed, what I saw was a white lady named Courtney Ross. She was his girlfriend for 3 years. He lived in Minneapolis with this white girl named Courtney Ross for 3 years. They did an interview with her on CNN. She says, George wouldn't want y'all to be rioting like this. But no, but with Stephen Jackson and all them Black Lives Matters and all that stupid black I Can't Breathe sweatshirts came on the news. They had some old black girl from Houston with some ugly long white fingernails doing the talking. He wasn't with her. He'd been living in Minneapolis with this white girl named Courtney for 3 years. But she was the person that the black people put in front of the cameras. They speak lies. That's the problem I got with this. Let's do this thing in 100% truth. None pleaded for truth. Plead for truth. the reason why you ain't pleading for truth is because you done choked truth to death. Because the cares for the black people, the cares for the world, the deceitfulness, I just almost, we want repercussions. Reparations for slavery. You want reparations. You want them to pay you some deceitfulness of riches. Chalk the word and it becoming unfruitful. Get off my Facebook page. They conceive mischief, annoying action. That's what they're doing today. They're doing a bunch of annoying action. They conceive annoying action against authority. And bring forth iniquity. And more grossly unfair behavior. Bringing it forth. Church people, professing Christians, my pastor friends, I see them putting it on Facebook. My minister friends, I see them putting it on Facebook. People that I know that love, that say they love God, putting it on Facebook, putting it on there. Telling me, and it's only telling me one thing. Their heart is not perfect towards Him. Who is Him? The God of love. Their eyes ain't perfect towards the eyes. And the way to know that their heart ain't perfect towards Him is you see the choking of love in their behavior, in their immoral behavior, in their iniquity. Pastors, wives, ministers of the gospel. People been going to church their whole life. And these events have climbed inside of their hearts and has choked the word of God to where they don't love no more. And they think they're doing something because they're out there in peaceful protests. Thinking that that is the right way. Protesting for something that ain't never going to manifest itself because the God of this world is not going to let it happen. Satan's not going to allow that to happen. Because for him to allow that to happen means that he's submitted in battle to God, who is love. He's not going to ever submit to love. We, as believers of God, should submit to love. Yes, Sister Selena, it's how people know we belong to Jesus because we have love for one another, understanding that we all have a thorn in our flesh, that the messenger of Satan is going to buffet us so that we won't be prideful. But you got some prideful people, Sister Selena, and the messenger of Satan can't buffet that pride out of them. As if they are flawless in their behavior. I tell you, they ain't flawless in their behavior. I tell you, the Bible says, hear me now. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 11, Moses, rather than enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. God bless you, Cooper. Thank you for joining. Happy Father's Day. It says, Moses, rather than enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season, forsook the riches of Egypt rather, he would rather suffer affliction with the people of God. You know what it says? Rather than enjoy the pleasures of sin. For sin. See, everything is based on a season. And I tell you, in this season, the word of God is getting choked to death by believers. Unbelievers ain't choking it. No. No, it ain't the unbelievers choking the word of God. It is the believers choking the word of God. Come on now. Watch this now. The sower sowed the word. Watch this. What is the second part that tells you that it's in the heart of the believer? Watch this. It says, let's go to the second part. We're going to the second part. And these are they, likewise, which are sown on stony ground, who when they have heard the word, immediately receive it with gladness. So they become believers. See, the first part, I can say they stay unbelievers. The second part, they became believers. They received it with God. They got happy and they received. But because they didn't allow Christ to become their life, they endured before time. But they were believers. Afterward, when affliction and persecution arises, that's the season. For the word's sake. What's the word say? Sister Selena just wrote it. Love. We should have love for one another. Immediately, they are offended. But here goes the third one. And these are they which are sown among thorns. Yeah. The believers, they're still in the Adamic, in our earth suit bodies, that God said was going to be cursed with thorns and thistles. But it's sown among the thorns, such as hear the word, these believers, and the cares of this world, and the deceitfulness, riches, and the lust of other things, because we lust for black lives to matter when Jesus is sitting up here and died for all lives. I don't care if you don't like my message. I'm a pastor. I preach unseen external living messages. Oh yeah, we want to fight for American rights, but there are black family members who hate each other. Oh yeah, Sister Selena. You're right. I'm going to tell you something right now. Y'all, you know what, we act like we ain't seen roots before. You know what, Joseph's brothers sold him into slavery, and that's how the children of Israel ended up in Egypt in bondage. You think the white man just decided he was going to jump in a boat and ride over to Africa and grab up a bunch of black people and enslave them? No! They sold them to the white man. Pastor Red, a black man, is in America. I tell you, if it was possible for God to trace my family tree back to how we got to America, I guarantee you I would put my entire military retirement check on it that I would find a black African selling my ancestors to a white man. Get off my Facebook page, because you don't want to hear that. You don't want to hear that. You want to hear what you want to hear. You don't want to hear the truth. Because you love choking the truth. You love choking the truth. But if you ever watch Roots, when Kunta Kinte went to get that material to build that drum for his little brother, oh yeah, it was black people that had him in that net. You act like y'all ain't watched Django. Django told Samuel L. Jackson, who was stealing all the stuff. Y'all thought that mess was funny. Y'all thought it was funny. Yeah, y'all thought it was funny. All y'all want to do is laugh. Ha, 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 ha. See, y'all would let black people abuse y'all and do y'all wrong and hate on each other. You better not let a white person or a police officer do it. Immediate death. Here in Augusta on the news, the sheriff came on. He said they put on there by like 38 gang members that they had finally rounded up. I was looking at the pictures, every last one of them was black. And he says, these 38 won't terrorize the projects they've been terrorizing no more. He says, and we still got some more that we got to round up. Blacks, terrorizing blacks in the projects. And y'all want to in the United States of America because one white man for 8.46 seconds took George Floyd's life, who was engaged to a white girl that he'd been dating for 3 years, but all you black people want to do is get up on the camera with a bunch of stupid black shirts on and say, I can't breathe, and then stick a black girl up on it with an ugly blue dress and ugly long white fingernails and say, when his daughter would cry, he would go in there and lay down with her. He lied. He was living in Minneapolis with that white girl. Shut up! Get off my Facebook page. I'm gonna preach the truth. I'm going to preach what even the people that know the truth, but don't want you to know the truth, won't tell you. You ain't no stupid person. You're not stupid. You're very smart. You're very smart. You got to hear everything. You cannot allow one's appearance, vanity, one's appearance to allow you to make the final check. Fact check that. Fact check this message that I've said to you today. Fact check Courtney Ross. Fact check how long George Floyd lived in Minneapolis with this lady. Fact check it. And then I want you to write me on Messenger, or you can write me on Facebook, and explain to me why they had this black girl, just because she's the mother of George Floyd's daughter. Then you got some Hollywood actor give George Floyd's daughter stock in Disney. Like George Floyd's daughter is going to be alive tomorrow. You don't know when death is going to come and get you. Okay, we allow Satan to fill our head with stupid knowledge that's why God told Adam. In the day that you eat from that tree, man, you're going to surely die, man. Why? Because that knowledge is going to choke out the life that you're going to hear from me throughout time. Throughout time, I'm going to do everything in my power to redeem you, to restore you. But this knowledge is going to choke it every time you hear it. And every time you hear it, it's going to take root. Sometimes you're going to allow it to take root, but other times you're going to limit me. My car, when I get in my car, it has 120 miles on the dash. But the authority limits it. Sometimes it limits it to where I can only drive it at 35. Sometimes it limits it at what I can drive it at 45. Sometimes it limits it to where I can drive it at 55, 65, 70. Limits it. I can never drive it at 120. God wants you to live at 100% capacity of love. But there is something in you that is choking that word and preventing him from being able to do it. The Bible says Jesus came unto his own, and his own received him not. Choking the word. Men love darkness rather than light. Darkness choking out the light. But you call yourself a Christian. You have no love in you. You have no love in you. Hate me all you want. Your behavior. Your iniquity is very loud. Your iniquity is very loud. Your vanity is brighter than the sun. Your perverseness is stronger than Samson before he had his hair cut. You are the most word-chokingest person that the eyes of God sees as it goes to and fro in the earth. To show himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect towards him. Oh, the person that, you find yourself in this message. You know who I'm talking to. This message ain't for everybody, but this message is to strengthen everybody. You know what? When I was a security manager, you know what? And I never heard this before until the safety manager had told me this. He said, "Mr. Red, you know what the purpose of security is?" I was like, "Yeah." Make sure the plan is secured. He's like, nope. He said, the purpose of security is to keep honest people honest. The purpose of law enforcement is to keep honest people honest. Unhonest people, racist people, nasty. People are going to be nasty, and they're going to be racist, and there is nothing that you can do about it, no matter how much you protest. So the word of God is to keep honest people honest. So there are honest people on this message today, but I know that your race, I know that your friends, I know that your family members are going to put pressure on you to choose sides. God bless you, Tim. I love you, brother. Oh, yeah, Brother Peace. Yeah, we desire to see ministries walking so we may not. Yeah, but let's don't choke. Let's don't choke ourselves by the breath of life. Let's don't do that. This message is to keep you honest, to keep you out of the war that's going on. Henceforth, As a therefore from henceforth thou shalt have war, stay out of the wars. They gon' you know, they gonna get mad if you don't come into the war with them. They want you in the war with them. I'm not coming into the war. I'm going to make sure that my heart is perfect towards the Christ, not towards black people. Because there ain't a black person on planet Earth that can keep me out of the lake of fire. But there is a word in this Holy Bible that can. But you know what the Christians is doing today?
Choking it.
They're choking. They're choking it. They're choking the word of God because of the cares of this world. Choking it. Choking the word of God. I hope that you have not been doing that. I hope that you have not been choking the word of God. I hope that you have not been choking it. The word of God. That's the air.
This is the air I breathe.
The word of God. That's the air I breathe. I don't breathe your words. I don't breathe your words.
This is the air I breathe.
This is the air I breathe.
Your holy presence living in me.
Yeah. I'm not choking it for you. I'm not choking it.
This is the air I breathe.
Come on, the
I breathe it every breath. I breathe it every day,
sweet body. Come on, tell
me. This is the air I breathe.
Come on, lift your hands to it, tell me.
Your Holy Spirit.
It's your presence, Lord. Your Holy Spirit that dwells on the inside. Lead us and guide us and
talk to me.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm not going to show it.
We thank you for the gift that you gave. And I don't know that when we talk about your word, it's my daily bread. It's what I long.
This is my daily bread.
And God, you said, he who hungers and thirsts after righteousness shall be feeded.
This is my
daily bread.
This verse says, your very word, God, tell them today.
Spoken. Yes, Lord.
So this is the part that I love to declare.
And I.
And I.
Yes, Lord. I'm desperate.
It says I'm desperate for you.
I'm desperate. I'm desperate.
Is there anybody here you just got?
I'm desperate for you. I'm desperate for you.
I've got to have you. Come to over this again.
You're supposed to love.
This is the air I breathe.
This is the air I breathe.
Come on, I want you to sing it with us. This is the air I breathe.
This is the air I breathe.
And because you sent your Holy Spirit, Lord, thank you that it is.
Your Holy
thank you, Jesus. It's living in me, hallelujah. I'm connected to you and you're connected to me. And I tell you today that this is my daily bread.
This is my daily bread.
Jesus.
This is my daily bread.
Yes,
this is what gives me nourishment to deal with.
Well, it is the truth of your word that you give me
from my race. From my family members, from my pastor friends,
Jesus.
From my church friends.
It to me. And if you
get the word, what you're doing, and I.
Thursday and every Sunday. You ain't gonna believe it. I'm desperate for Jesus. I know this. Desperate for the word of God as your pastor is. As your friend, Mr. Red is. Are you? As desperate for God as I am.
To the Father, and they start this word off in this song by talking to the Father. God bless you, Bridget. I love you. You and your husband. Happy Father's Day to my friend Harris. Father, it's Father's Day. Let's tell our Father. Help your children. Don't let them fall.
And don't let them fall.
By the side.
By the side.
Of the road.
Road.
Thank you, Jesus. Mm-hmm. And he said to do what?
To love one another.
That heaven
might rise.
Not the earth, but heaven.
A place in our heart.
And I hope that they don't choke it when it gets in there.
Jesus.
Oh yeah, Brother Beats.
He won't let you down.
So why we choking it?
And I know he
in my heart. I hope you ain't been choking.
Forever.
I hope you ain't been choking. That word is in your heart. Love
in my heart.
Your fellow man. You know why we choking it? Because we won't. We choke it because we won't walk on. Walk on through temptation. Cause he love and his wisdom will be our seat so we don't have blood on our hands and iniquity on our face. I know the truth. And his word will be our deliverance from sin. But we've been choking it. Lift up our. See, you'll lift up your hands, but you won't lift up your heart. And glad, because Jesus,
the Jesus, is not.
Because
he won't
lie to us. We've been told a bunch of lies.
And I know.
what? I'm trying to figure out how you're able to choke it. I'm trying to figure out how you're able to choke it. I'm trying to figure out how you're able to choke it. Seventeen police officers quit the Atlanta police force. We are heading to days of lawlessness. We are heading to days of lawlessness. All because you want to have, you want to make a Black Lives Matter movement out of something that is vanity, excessive pride in one's appearance. Unconfused me. Are we mad at the white people? Are we mad at the law enforcement? Unconfused me. Because you better not do the Black Lives Matter thing. Because I'm telling you, blacks is killing blacks at a rate unprecedented in this country. Do not do that. Do not do that. We're choking the word. We're choking the word. We're choking love. And it's being led. The choking is being led by church people. Yeah, church people. Church people I got pastor friends that post on Facebook what T.I. and Killer Mike said at the podium in Atlanta, as if they've never read Psalms 1 and 1. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. As if you've never heard Psalms 1 and 1 before. I'm disgusted at my pastor friends and ministers and church people. Disgusted with this. Because I've been serving with you for so long, and I can't believe that this is what it comes down to. You're showing me that you really ain't the loving person that you've been telling me that you are. Let the wars be fought by the worldly people. Stay in the ark. stay out of carnal warfare battles that are being fought with carnal weapons, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God to the casting down imaginations and the and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. I have them same thoughts, but I allow the word of God to cast it down rather than choke it. If I will ever talk to my pastor friends again and nobody mentioned, I don't care. God's been blessing me. I want to thank y'all for praying for me for the job that I put in for. I went and interviewed for the job twice. They called me on Friday. I was willing to take a $3 pay cut just to move jobs so I can get this job so I never have to leave out of Augusta again, never have to miss a church service again. They called me Friday. They was like, you got the job. We're not going to change your pay. We're going to pay you the same pay. We're going to take you from salary to hourly so you can work overtime and make more money. You'll be the assistant, not the assistant safety manager, not the primary safety manager. Everything I wanted. I tell you, that then God increased my VA disability from 20% to 60%, and I still got two things that's out there that is probably worse than the other ones that they gave me the 40% rating on. Probably be 100% when they look at them. And you think that God is opening up the windows of heaven and blessing me? You think I'm thinking about you? He's showing me that his eyes are going to and fro in the earth to prove himself strong on the behalf of them whose heart is perfect towards him. You think I'm thinking about y'all? No, I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing. I'm going to keep preaching the way I'm preaching. I'm going to keep teaching the way I'm teaching. And I'm going to keep allowing these blessings to overrun my life. And you go on and live your defeated life if you want to. Not going to happen this way. God is good. God is good. I hope he's good to you. Thank you, Sister Ann. I love you. I love you. Amen. I hope y'all enjoyed today's word. Stop choking the word of God when you hear it. Stop choking. My name is Pastor Red. I will see you Thursday night at 7 p.m. with another word from on high. I love you. God bless you. Have a happy Father's Day. I want to remember, thank you, Lord. Remember to keep our sister Beverly Conyers Evans in prayer. Beverly, Sister Beverly. We all know Sister Beverly. Amen. She's fighting that doggone cancer demon. We want to keep her in prayer. I love this. And Sister Beverly. But Sister Beverly was with me when it seemed like everybody else had abandoned ship. She's been there the whole time. She is my heart. She is my heart. And I want to make sure that I know that the Christ Alive Ministries, that we continue to bombard heaven with the name of Beverly Conyers Evans. Beverly Conyers Evans. Every time you pray, please put Beverly Conyers Evans on your prayer list. I love you all. Thank you, Brother Peachy, Sister Selena, my sister Ann, all of you in attendance, Sister Peachy. I love y'all, Kobe. Everybody out there that I can't see your name, I love you. Thank you for joining me. See you Thursday night at 7 p.m., God willing. Amen and amen.